Good morning, students. Today we are going to do the second part of the lesson, The Sound of Music, the Shehnai of Bismillah Khan. This chapter throws light on the life of Bismillah Khan, famous Shehnai player and the winner of Bharat Ratna Award, which is the highest civilian award of India, and his love for India and dedication to music. He is a legend because he did something which has historical significance. He played the Shehnai on the day India got independence, that is 15th August 1947. At the Red Fort, before the Prime Minister of India, Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, gave his speech, and before that, Bismillah Khan played the Shehnai in order to signify something auspicious. Something auspicious for the whole country was about to happen, that is, India was about to get freed. So, let us start our lesson. Emperor Aurangzeb banned the playing of a musical instrument called pungi in the royal residence, for it had a shrill, unpleasant sound. Pungi became the generic name for reeded noisemakers. Few had thought it would one day be revived. A barber of a family of a professional musicians who had access to royal palace decided to improve the tonal quality of the pungi. He chose a pipe with a natural hollow stem that was longer and broader than the pungi and made 7 holes on the body of the pipe. When he played on it, closing and opening some of these holes, soft and melodious sounds were produced. Emperor Aurangzeb, he was a Mughal emperor, and before the Britishers ruled our country, there was Mughal Empire, and Emperor Aurangzeb was a famous emperor. He banned the playing of musical instrument called pungi in his palace because he thinks that it had a very shrill and unpleasant sound. Pungi became the generic name. Generic name means a name given to a class or group as a whole. For reeded noisemaker, reeded means wind instruments which have reeds like flute, clarinet, etc. So, he banned pungi in his palace. A barber of a family of professional musicians who had access to royal palace decided to improve the tonal quality of the pungi. A barber of the family of professional musicians who used to go to the royal palace, he decided to improve its quality. What he did? He chose a pipe with natural hollow stem that was longer and broader than the pungi, and he made 7 holes on its body, and when he played it, while closing and opening some of the holes, some soft and melodious sounds were produced from it. He played the instrument before royalty and everyone was impressed. The instrument was so different from pungi, had to be given a new name, as the story goes. And since it was first played in Shah's chamber and was played by a Nai, that is barber, the instrument was named as Shehnai. So he played the instrument before the royal palace, in the royal palace, and everyone was very much impressed by its sweet and melodious sound. So this instrument is very different from pungi, so it is to be given a different name, a new name. And there is a story behind its name, and it is said it was first played in Shah's chamber. Shah means emperor's chamber, and it was played by a Nai, a barber. So the instrument was named as Shehnai. The sound of Shehnai began to be considered auspicious, and for this reason it is played in the temples and is an indispensable component of any North Indian wedding. In the past, Shehnai was a part of the Naubat or traditional ensemble of nine instruments found at Royal Court. Till recently, it was used only in temples and weddings. The credit for bringing this instrument onto the classical stage goes to Bismillah Khan. So, the sound of Shehnai began to be considered auspicious. Auspicious means promising to bring good fortune. And for this reason, it is still played in temples and it has become a necessary part of North Indian weddings. And in past, Shehnai was a part of Naubat. What is Naubat? Naubat is a group of nine instruments that used to be played at royal courts. And now it is used, till now it is used in temples and weddings. And Bismillah Khan first brought this instrument to the classical stage. As a 5 year old, Bismillah Khan played Gilli Danda near a pond in the ancient state of Dumrao in Bihar. He would regularly go to nearby Bihariji temple to sing the Bhojpuri Chaita, at the end of which he would earn a big laddu weighing 1.25 kg, a prize given by local Maharaj. And this happened 80 years ago, and the little boy has travelled far to earn the highest civilian award in India, the Bharat Ratna. When Bismillah Khan, he was a young child of 5 years, he used to play Gilli Danda near a pond in the ancient state of Dumrao in Bihar, and there was Bihariji's temple near the pond, and he used to sing Bhojpuri Chaita in that temple. And at the end of his song, Maharaj of that area used to give him a big laddu weighing 1.25 kg as a reward. This happened 80 years ago, and the little boy has traveled far to earn highest civilian award in India, the Bharat Ratna. Means as a young boy, he used to earn a big laddu as a prize, and after 80 years, when he was 80 years old, he got the highest civilian award in India, that is Bharat Ratna Award. Born on 21st March 1916, Bismillah belongs to a well-known family of musicians from Bihar. His grandfather, Rasool Bakhsh Khan, was a Shehnai Nawaz of Bhojpur King's Court, and his father, Peghambar Bakhsh, and other paternal ancestors were also great Shehnai players. So, he was born in a family of musicians. He was born on 21st March 1916. And his grandfather's name was Rasool Bakhsh Khan. He was a famous Shehnai player at Bhojpur King's Court. And his father, Peghambar Bakhsh, and his uncles, his other paternal ancestors were also great Shehnai players. The young boy took to music early in his life. At the age of 3, when his mother took him to her uncle's house in Banaras, now Varanasi, Bismillah was fascinated watching his uncles practice the Shehnai. Soon Bismillah started accompanying his uncle Ali Bakhsh to the Vishnu temple of Banaras, where Bakhsh was employed to play the Shehnai. Ali Bakhsh would play the Shehnai and Bismillah would sit captivated for hours on end. Slowly he started getting lessons in playing the instruments and would sit practicing throughout the day. For years to come, the temple of Balaji and Mangala Maya and banks of Ganga became the young apprentice's favorite haunts where he could practice in solitude. The flowing waters of Ganga inspired him to improvise and invent ragas that were earlier considered to be beyond the range of the Shehnai. The young boy took to music early in life, means he started learning music early in his life when he was very young. And at the age of 3, when his mother took him to his maternal uncle's house in Banaras, now it is known as Varanasi, he was very much impressed watching his uncle practicing shehnai. So he started accompanying his uncle, whose name was Ali Baksh, to Vishnu Temple of Banaras, where Ali Baksh was employed to play the shehnai. He used to play shehnai there. Ali Baksh would play shehnai and Bismillah Khan would sit captivated for hours on end. Captivated means attracted. He used to sit nearby him and he was very much fascinated by his shehnai. Slowly he started getting lessons in playing the instrument and would sit practicing throughout the day. So he was so much devoted that he started getting his lessons and would practice for many hours in the day. For years to come, the temple of Balaji, Mangalamaya and banks of Ganga became the young apprentice. Apprentice means training. Favorite haunts where he could practice in solitude means at the banks of Gangamaya, Mangalamaya, Balaji temple, he used to practice there in solitude. Solitude means loneliness, alone. The flowing waters of Ganga inspired him to improvise and invent ragas that were earlier considered to be beyond the range of shehnai. So he was so much fascinated by the flowing water of Ganga that he was inspired to improve and invent many ragas which were not earlier played on shehnai. At the age of 14, Bismillah accompanied his uncle to Allahabad Music Conference, and at the end of his recital, Ustad Faiz Khan patted the young boy's back and said, "Work hard and you shall make it." And with the opening of the All India Radio in Lucknow in 1938 came Bismillah's big break. He soon became an often heard shehnai player on radio. And when he was 14 years old, he accompanied his uncle to Allahabad Music Conference. He performed there and Ustad Faiz Ali Khan, he patted the boy and he encouraged him to work hard and you will get a big name in this field. And when All India Radio was opened in Lucknow in 1938, he got a big break and he used to play shehnai there often. When India gained independence on 15th August 1947, Bismillah Khan became the first Indian to greet the nation with his shehnai. He poured his heart out into Rag Cafe from the Red Fort to an audience which included Mahatma Gandhi, Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, who later gave his famous Rise with Destiny speech. And when on 15th August 1947, when India got independence, he was the first Indian to play shehnai on Red Fort, and he played this Rag Cafe before Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru's speech as to mark this auspicious occasion. Bismillah Khan has given many memorable performances both in India and abroad. His first trip abroad was to Afghanistan, where King Jahir Shah was so taken in by the maestro that he gifted him priceless Persian carpets and other souvenirs. The King of Afghanistan was not the only one to be fascinated with Bismillah's music. Film director Vijay Bhatt was so impressed after hearing Bismillah play at festival that he named a film on it, Goonj Uthi Shehnai. So Bismillah Khan, he gave many memorable performances both in India and in other countries also, and his first trip abroad was to Afghanistan. And King Zahir Shah, he was so much impressed by his shehnai playing that he gifted him many gifts, many souvenirs, and he also gifted him priceless Persian carpet. And he was very much fascinated. And the film director Vijay Bhatt, he was also so impressed after hearing Bismillah Shehnai that he named his film after the instrument and called the film Goonj Uthi Shehnai. The film was a hit and one of the Bismillah Khan's compositions दिल का खिलौना हाई टूट गया, टर्न आउट टू बी अ नेशन वाइड चार्ट बस्टर. चार्ट बस्टर मीन्स रिकॉर्ड ब्रेकर. तो दिल का खिलौना हाई टूट गया सॉन्ग बिकेम वेरी फेमस इन इंडिया. डिस्पाइट दिस ह्यूज सक्सेस इन सेलुलॉयड वर्ल्ड, बिस्मिल्ला खान्स वेंचर इन फिल्म म्यूजिक वर लिमिटेड टू टू. विजय भट्ट गूंज उठी शहनाई एंड विक्रम श्रीनिवासन कन्नड़ वेंचर सनाधि अपन्ना. I just cannot come to terms with the artificiality and glamour of the film world, he says with emphasis. Although he got a great success in this film world, his ventures in the film music was limited only to two films, Goonj Uthi Shehnai by Vijay Bhatt and a Kannad movie made by Vikram Srinivasa Sanadhi Appan. Ustad Bismillah Khan would say that he didn't like the artificiality of the films and glamour that was there in the film world. That is why he didn't compose music for many more movies. Awards and recognition came thick and fast. Bismillah Khan became the first Indian to be invited to perform at the prestigious Lincoln Center Hall in the United States of America. He also took part in World Exposition in Montreal, in the Cannes Art Festival and in Osaka Trade Fair. So well known did he become internationally that an auditorium in Tehran was named after him, Tahar Mahsk Ustad Bismillah. So he got many awards for his performances and he gave many performances and other countries also. He became the first Indian to perform at the prestigious Lincoln Center Hall in United States of America. He took part in World Exposition in Montreal also, in Cannes Art Festival, Osaka Trade Fair, and he became famous internationally. And in Tehran, an auditorium was named after his name. National awards like Padma Shri, the Padma Bhushan, Padma Vibhushan were conferred on conformance given to him. So he got many national awards like Padma Shri, Padma Bhushan, Padma Vibhushan, etc. In 2001, Ustad Bismillah Khan was awarded India's highest civilian award, the Bharat Ratna. And with the coveted award resting on his chest, and his eyes glinting with rare happiness, he said, "All I would like to say is, teach your children music. This is the Hindustan's richest tradition. Even the West is now coming to learn your music." And when Ustad Bismillah Khan received India's highest civilian award, that is Bharat Ratna, in year 2001, his eyes were shining and he was very happy because his hard work has been recognized, and he gave an important message to the country. He told all the Indians to teach music to their children because music is the richest tradition of India. He said that even the Western countries wanted to learn India's music. Despite of having travelled all over the world, Khan Saab, as he is fondly called, is exceedingly fond of Banaras and Dumrao, and they remain for him the most wonderful towns of the world. Although Ustad Bismillah Khan had travelled all over the world, he has given so much respect and recognition to his towns Banaras and Dumrao, where he was born and brought up, and for him these are the two most wonderful towns of the world. He was so down to earth that although he had travelled all over the world, still he was attached to his birthplace. A student of his once wanted him to head a Chennai school in the USA, and the student promised to recreate the atmosphere of Banaras by replicating the temples there. But Khansa asked him if he would be able to transport river Ganga as well. So once his student, a student of Ustad Bismillah Khan, wanted him to set up a Chennai school in the USA, and he promised that he would recreate the temple of Banaras in America. But Ustad Ali Khan, Ustad Bismillah Khan was so much attached to his river Ganga that he asked his students that would he be able to transport the river Ganga also. So he wanted to say that he could not leave India. He was attached not only to the temples of Banaras but also to the river Ganga. Later he is remembered to have said that is why whenever I am in a foreign country I keep yearning to see Hindustan while in Mumbai. I think only of Banaras and the holy Ganga, and while in Banaras I miss the unique mutt of Dumra. He said that whenever he visited any foreign country he longed to see India. He wanted to return to India. And then he says that when he is in India, in Mumbai, he wanted to visit Banaras and the Ganga River. And when he was in Banaras, he missed his birthplace Dumra and the Matha where he sang Chaita and was rewarded with the prize of Laddu. Ustad Bismillah Khan's life is a perfect example of the rich cultural heritage of India, one that effortlessly accepts that a devout Muslim like him can very naturally play the Shehnai every morning at the Kashi Vishwanath temple. So Ustad Bismillah Khan is a perfect example of the rich cultural heritage of India. His work was beyond the religion barriers. Although he was a strict Muslim, he followed the Muslim laws, but every morning he would play the Shehnai at Kashi Vishwanath temple, which was a Hindu temple. This shows that he didn't have the barriers of religion in his mind. He was a true Indian. He considered music to be India's richest cultural heritage.